Many researchers have argued that key factors behind persistently low corporate investment in Europe is low aggregate demand, high levels of uncertainty, and a very sick financial sector. But now we are 10 years out of the financial crisis, and we believe what we call debt overhang, that is a high levels of corporate indebtedness, leverage and debt at the firm level, is a very big contributor to this low persistent investment. Why is that? Because if you enter to the crisis as a firm with a lot of debt, a lot of leverage, you have to deliver. And that deleveraging process can take a long time, even up to a decade. This is actually a pretty difficult problem, which is why we think a big data approach is the best approach to solve this problem. We have over 2 million observations matching each firm to its bank and the banks to its sovereign in 8 European countries. So just that matching process took us a year. We find that high leverage, high debt overhang at the firm level holds back corporate investment. But it's also true that if the firm tied to a weak bank, because bank's sovereign gets under stress and bank hold that sovereign debt, that also has an effect on low firm level investment. Moreover, we have this extra result that there is rollover risk. If you enter the crisis with a lot of short-term debt during the crisis and the aftermath of the crisis, you have to keep rolling over that debt. And it becomes very hard to do that when your bank is also weak. Together, this debt overhang and rollover risk channel at the firm level can explain 60% of the aggregate corporate sector investment decline in Europe. If we only focus on financial policies like bank recapitalization or monetary policies to keep interest rates low, these policies, of course, they're important policies and they're going to help to a certain degree, but they are not going to solve the problem completely, right? Because you have to deal with these very indebted corporate sector.